New song is out very soon. Yes. Tell us about it.
Talk You Down. It's about that kind of flight or fight moment where, in a relationship, when it breaks up, there's the girl's after leaving and, you know, after having a big fight, and there's a guy's kind of standing there and he's having a cigarette, you know, kind of just looking out the window, and he realizes by the time the cigarette is completely gone, it's about 3 minutes, 3 or 4 minutes. Mm. So he realizes that she could only be that far down the road. So he decides to just, that's it, out the door, in the car, straight afterward to try and to get the relationship back on track again. And it touches on a unique subject of a word, relationship suicide. That if she's willing to end this right now by leaving, and in that it's the end of the relationship, but it's also the end of you. If she goes, then I go. If she goes, then I go. You know, that's kind of the sentiment behind the song.
Which one of you is it about?
Silence.
It ends up just being sometimes when we end up getting the rumours, there's a little bit of us all in there sometimes.
Has it been easier to get girls in the last year?
Very easy.
Yeah.
We were just saying, no one would touch us before because we're ugly shams walking down the street, but now you hold a microphone, everyone wants you.
Yeah. Brilliant. Magic. It's
hilarious.
It's brilliant.
It is great. Music is good for you. Get into music.
Yes.
And of course, you've got 5 dates coming up at the Shepherd's Bush Empire very soon.
We can't believe that. Honestly, playing Shepherd's Bush in the first place, it's one of our favourite venues. It was even the sound system. For a band, it's fantastic experience. And we played two nights there the last time, which we were really shocked about. And then it came, we played two nights at the Roundhouse, we're going, how far can we take this? Then all of a sudden we get booked for 5 nights. Yeah.
And I'd love to say, please go and buy tickets, but
sold out.
I mean, literally, like, clicking your fingers.
That's not bad, is
it? I know, yeah, it's really, really good.
Good news as well, V Festival tickets went on sale.
That's right.
That has completely sold out.
Has it sold out?
Wicked.
Well, wicked. What a great festival as well.
I know, and all they needed to say was the script was on the bill. No. But, yeah, you know, we this band was literally, but we played our first gig at V-Fest.
That's right.
Last year.
Mm. And that's on YouTube and nobody knew who we were. It was classic.
I think there was 10 people in the tent or something. Yeah. That was the first time. But last year we played it again and the new band.
Two years ago, yeah.
What does V-Festival mean to you? Obviously, it means that. Is it also a chance to just do, you know, a big crowd in the sunshine?
Most other festivals, V-Fest does it a little bit differently. You know, generally, the organisation and everything else around V-Fest is brilliant because it's not as, I suppose, the muddy experience doesn't really... I mean, although the location they choose doesn't get too crazy as far as rain and mud and all goes. And in general, the way the layout of it is very, very cool. But, you know, V-Festival in general, going up there and playing the new band's tent last year was fantastic, off the chain, honest to God. Especially when we played it the year before with no one there. So you always look forward to these experiences because festivals are just cool to be at in general.
I think a big factor for us is actually the anticipation of will there be people there? Do you know what I mean?
It's always that way.
We're always kind of like that. It's kind of...
It's like a birthday party. Will they
really
actually turn up? You know, and
very humble in that way.
This year, everyone will know the song, so it'll be a bit of a sing song.
Yeah.
Is it an ambition to kind of do an Alanis Morissette Ironic or a Robbie Williams and Angels, where you actually can just sit back and chill out and let everybody else sing?
Believe it's kind of happening to us right now with the Man Who Can't Be Moved. Most nights, you can actually go out there and go break and just hold the mic out and they just sing it for you. You know.
Yeah, it's mad. Man Who Can't Be Moved, you know, we've done, what, maybe 15 cities in the past 20 days all around Europe. And it's the same, even if they speak French, Swedish, German, they're all singing every lyric of the songs. It's an amazing, amazing thing, you know, really. As a band, it makes you just step up your game and makes the hair on the back of your neck stand up on end. You're literally like, all these people singing lines from songs that you've written in your bedroom or just a concept in your own head, and it's a magical, magical moment for any musician out there. Yeah. But hopefully we'll get one or two songs like that, you know.
Wicked. Next album, when do you start work on that? Because that's obviously what everybody else kind of wants
to know
about.
It's kind of started already, you know, since the record company kind of prized the album out of our hands, because even the first album is not exactly finished, but it's only finished when they pull it out of your hands.
Yeah.
So from that point, you know, we're all individually very, very creative. So you're always conceptualizing ideas or things people say, and you're like, oh, that's really interesting, write that down. Mm. We've now had, you know, the past year has been just all over the place as far as countries we've been to, things we've been experiencing, and just generally you're filling up that tank of creativity that you're going to start writing out again. And you know, it started even in America. We went over, did a little stint in the studio, and we were just going in to kind of just go back, kick back for a little while, get back into producing, and bosh, two songs came out. So
it's great.
Like we're right on the verge of, you know, getting back in again and just, you know,
working the muscle,
doing what we do best.